One day at school, Gabby Lopez came up to me and asked if we were related. I said, "Yeah, he's my brother." She asked, "So, you like your brother?" I answered, "Well, I have to live with him, so why not?" Then she came over to you and asked, "Do you love your sister?" Without hesitation, you said, "Yes, I love her. I love her very much." Gabby came up to me and asked if I loved you. I looked over at you and said, "Yeah, I love him a lot." She smiled, "Oh, that's cute." I didn't care what Gabby, the popular girl, thought about us. We were a team. We had older siblings and a younger sibling, but we were in the middle, like twins. I grew up following you, playing rough, competing, racing, trying to catch up with you. I remember the time when we went to Oxbow Park. We heard some people say that it was hard to get over to the other side of the river because it was so deep. You went ahead of me to test the rocks and to see if the path was stable enough for me to pass. Even though I couldn't touch the bottom of the river, I felt so safe because you always said, "I got your back." When we made it to the other side, we saw a rope tied onto the branch of a big tree. You said, "Come on," and I followed. You grabbed the rope and asked me to push you. You swung so high, then jumped off into the river. I was so happy and excited to try it next. You swam back to give me a push. I was scared, but since I saw you do it, I knew that I could do it too. I flew into the water with butterflies in my stomach. We proved them all wrong. But that was before your accidents. The first accident was when you chased after a football and hit your head on the bleachers. Mom took you to the emergency room. The ER doctor asked you your name, and there was a long pause before you responded. You denied it. At the time, I didn't take it seriously. I thought it was funny. I would call your name and see how long it would take you to say, What do you want?" Then it happened again. It was during wrestling practice. You got hit in the head again. I knew it was because you were still slow. You weren't back to your old self. Mom forbid you to wrestle. You yelled, "That's not fair. You're taking away something I love. I love sports. Sports are my life." Then came the baseball championships. You were trying to tag the runner coming home. You thought that he would slide into home plate. Instead, both of you collided. You went to the ER for the third time in less than a year. You had a broken arm and a sprained neck. Before you got your bone popped back in, our older sister snapped a picture of you proudly holding up a baseball. You posted it on Facebook, and I told you that you were such a dork. You didn't care. You liked the attention. After the accidents, you complained about headaches. You had to take a lot of aspirin, but they didn't work. You would say you'd tough it out. Mom took you to the doctors to run some more tests. I didn't know what was wrong with you, but I did know that something was wrong. You died on a regular Monday. We were getting ready to go to school. It was almost summertime, warm, sunny. We walked home together with our friends. We all jaywalked the intersection. You joked, "Oh, I'm so bad, I jaywalked." All of our friends laughed. When we got home, we saw that Mom had already made dinner, chicken and rice. Mom and our sisters weren't home yet, but we didn't wait. When Mom came home, she was mad. She had wanted us to all eat together. You had took the blame and let me go change from a softball game. Mom didn't want you to go to the game because of the argument. As I was getting in the car, you yelled something, but I couldn't make it out. Then you slammed the door. That was the last time that I saw you alive. After the game, Mom felt bad about the argument, so we stopped at a Mexican store. And we picked up a vanilla cake with frosting and cherries. You loved sweets. We were coming up the walkway. Wendy, our older sister, had your cake. When we got to the gate, we couldn't get it open. I had to pull it up and push it away because Mom was very frustrated with the gate. Mom unlocked the front door. Wendy was standing beside her with her cake in one hand and holding Barrett's hand with the other. Mom started to scream. Wendy started screaming as well. I was still trying to close the gate. Wendy dropped the cake. She started to run away, but slipped on the cake. Barrett collapsed with her. Wendy yelled for me to run. I ran into the house to see how I could help my mom. That's when I saw that you had died. I can't remember what all happened that night. I tried to run for help, but I couldn't get the gate open. A police car was passing by. I yelled, "Police, stop! Over here!" The policeman opened the gate and called on his radio for an ambulance. Now that you are no longer here, I have no one to play with. I miss your laugh, and most of all, I miss your smile that went from ear to ear. I also miss the smell of your Old Spice deodorant and your Head & Shoulders shampoo. I miss your weird tippy-toe runner's walk. I even miss the smell of your old stinky running shoes. Now because of you, I do track and field, and I have even placed at the county track championship, just like you. When I'm running a race, I hear your voice. When I'm almost to the finish line, I hear you say, "Don't give up." Also with wrestling, before you passed away, you taught me the full Nelson. And I said, "That really hurts a lot." He said, "That's because it's illegal." "Well, why are you teaching it to me then?" I asked. "Because it's fun." I wish that you were still here. I want some more memories with you. We used to talk about joining the Marines and serving together, but we won't get to do that. We've talked about entering the amazing race, and when we won, splitting the prize. We talked about going on a mission trip and adopting children from a third world country and training them to be gymnasts and to compete against each other, just like us. We will never get to finish these things together, but even if I have to do them on my own, I will. The most important lesson that you taught me was to never, ever give up.